to BibliLit. In this video, we are going to discuss the poem For Anne Gregory, which is written by William Butler Yeats. The poem begins with the lines, "Never shall a young man thrown into despair by those great honey-colored ramparts at your ear love you for yourself alone and not your yellow hair." So, in the very opening stanza of the poem, the speaker is addressing Anne Gregory, and he says that her beautiful honey-colored hair can make any man fall in love with her. And this love is not for the girl, Anne Gregory, but the love is for the hair. Because her hair is so gorgeous and beautiful that the person would fall in love with the hair but not with the girl or the person who the girl is. And the beauty that is external of the girl is actually preventing the person to know what sort of person the girl is, how deep she is. They are unable to explore her inner beauty. Because of her outer beauty, they are not able to understand and analyze and get to know the inner beauty of the girl. This is what makes the speaker believe that no man can love Anne for what she is without her beauty. One can love her for her honey-colored hair and beauty. So a man can love only this girl because of her external beauty, because she is very beautiful. And because of that, no one is going to try and get to know her inner self. And therefore, she would not be loved for who she is, but only for what she is. That is, what she is on the outside and not who she is in person. We just saw that the first stanza was a person or a speaker. We don't know exactly who the speaker is. It might be the poet, it might be some lover or friend of Anne. So in the first stanza, the speaker is trying to convey something to Anne. It's a conversational sort of thing. The person is saying this to Anne Gregory. In the second stanza, Anne Gregory is going to give a reply to the speaker. The second stanza begins with the lines, "But I can get a hair dye and set such color there, brown or black or carrot, that young men in despair may love me for myself alone and not my yellow hair." So we see in the second stanza, Anne is giving a reply to the speaker, and she says that she can get a hair dye and color her hair brown or black or carrot color, just the color that would change her outer beauty in a way that the man may not look at just her outer beauty but try to know her inner self. Anne wants to emphasize that anyone falling in love with her must not think outer beauty is important, but must see her as a person, as a whole. She means that young man falling in love with her must see her persona and not just her physical attributes. So in the second stanza, it is emphasized upon that whatever we see on the outside, whatever is visible from the outside, is superficial and unnecessary. The outer beauty is not necessary, but what sort of person Anne is, that is important. "I heard an old religious man but yesternight declare that he had found a text to prove that only God, my dear, could love you for yourself alone and not your yellow hair." So in the third stanza, the speaker is giving a reply to Anne Gregory, and she was stating that internal beauty is important and not external. So this is a reply from the speaker, and he says that he had heard an old religious man saying that he had some text to prove that only God was someone who could see beyond external beauty. The speaker means to say that humans do not have the capacity to look beyond the external. They cannot try to know the soul. They are fixed upon the external beauty and not the eternal and internal being of a person. Humans are always carried away by the glitter and glamour in the outward form. They do not try to seek souls, they do not try to look beyond the physical realm and beyond what the outward show is. People do not try to know the inward nature, the inward person. They just see a person from the outside. They are attracted by how they look and they just start to be with them or like them for who they are on the outward side, but not who they are inwards. Like, what sort of person that person would be doesn't matter, because people do not see on the inside. What they see is only on the outside. God alone has this capacity, the poet says, that God alone has the capacity to love Anne Gregory for beauty that is within, not just beauty that is on the outside, not just who she is on the outside, but what sort of person she is on the inside, and only God can love her like that. The poet is trying to pay a tribute indirectly to the internal beauty of Anne Gregory. I recall that there is a text in which it is proved that God doesn't look just on the outside. We see in the Bible when Samuel went to anoint King David, there is a story in which there is a prophet who goes to anoint a young little shepherd boy. So the shepherd boy is named David, and Samuel goes to anoint the next king. So David had a lot of brothers who were very smart, physically fit in the army. They were more tall, more strong, and David was a lean and thin boy. He used to work in the fields and he used to be a shepherd, and he was in the field, and so he was not like his brothers in appearance. He looked very different from his brothers. So when Samuel went to anoint, he didn't think that David would be the one, because on the outward side he looked very unfit to be the next king. Like, physically he was not that strong as his brothers, or not as good looking as his brothers, but he was the chosen king who God had chosen to be the next king. So in 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 7, the Lord said to Samuel, "For the Lord sees not as man sees. Man looks on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." So here we see a text in which it is clearly stated that God sees at the heart. He knows how you are on the inside. He knows that you are man and woman, and we all are sinners. He can see that we are sinners, but yet he looks at our heart, and yet he forgives us for our sins and blesses us with his grace and mercy. Because God sees at the heart, he knows the intentions we have in our heart. He doesn't just judge us based on how we are, what sin we've done, what sort of person we are on the outside, but he knows who we are within. Now, let us quickly take a look at the poetic devices used in the poem. The rhyme scheme of the poem is AB, CB, DB. Alliteration is used in the poem. Alliteration means repetition of consonant sounds in the same line. And "not your yellow hair, why" is repeated. "Could love you for yourself alone." L is repeated. Consonant sound is repeated here. A metaphor is used in the first stanza when the poet compares the honey-colored hair of Anne Gregory with ramparts. Ramparts, which is a protecting wall around a fort, outer part of the ear, etc. So a metaphor is used in the poem when in the lines he says honey-colored ramparts. These were the literary devices in the poem. Thank you for watching this video.